Can a true believer practice sin? Can a true believer, if a person has saving faith, can a true believer practice sin? And the answer is yes. Whosoever is born of God doth not commit sin, for his seed remaineth in him, and he cannot sin because he is born of God. Okay, and the standard interpretation of this verse is that while all born-again people on this earth are still sinners, we cannot habitually practice sin. Now, that doesn't fit the true experience of the vast majority of Christians. The fact is that we all have weaknesses, we all have besetting sins, and it says the sin which doth so easily beset us. Okay? We all have sins that, unfortunately, we do the same things over and over and over and over again. And if that's not practice, then what is it? They say, whosoever is born of God doth not commit sin, and this is present continuous tense, and it means to habitually practice. And if you're really saved, you cannot practice sin. You will sin occasionally, very occasionally sometimes, but you will not practice sin. Okay, now let's look at this. The word commit is the word poeo in the Greek, and it means do. Okay, whosoever is born of God doth not do sin. Present continuous, it simply means that you're doing it at the present time. Okay, it doesn't necessarily mean over and over and over and over again. It says you cannot do sin. Why? For his seed remaineth in him. He cannot sin because he's born of God. I think this very clearly is talking about your new birth. And your new birth is perfect. Your new birth is holy. It cannot sin. The problem is you've still got your old birth. Okay? Which does sin. For the good that I would, I do not. But the evil which I would not, that I do. I want to do right, but I don't do it. And guess what? The word here is poeo, and it's in the present tense. You fall into sin, you do something wrong, and you're kicking yourself, and the Holy Spirit's convicting you, and you say, man, I wish I could stop this. Okay, you don't want to do it. That I do. This is a different Greek word for do. It's the word proso. The definition, the meaning of the word is practice. That's what the word means. Okay, the good that I want to do, I don't do. The evil that I wish I didn't do, I practice. I do it all the time. Now, this is the Apostle Paul speaking. He's being very honest with us that we have a new nature, we have an old nature. Okay? And the new nature only does good, the old nature only does bad. And unfortunately, it does it a whole lot more than it ought to.